Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In our previous class, we have been discussed about the gene interaction. Gene interaction means, you know very well, so the due to gene interaction, what happened means the phenotypic character, it will get modified. You know, already we have been discussed in our previous class. So whichever the characters are present in our body, so each character, it is held by one gene. And always the gene, it will be in a pair in condition. That means it contains the two alleles. Example, capital T, small t, capital R, smaller, smaller. These are all are nothing but a single gene. This is one gene, this is one gene, this is one gene. And each gene, it contains the two alleles. Where these genes they will sit means they will sit on the chromosomes. So on which place they will sit? That place we are calling it as a locus. And it will sit on the, it will sit on the chromosome. And it will holds the character, but due to interaction of the another gene, because they will be present in the pair, that means it contains the two alleles it contains. So in another genes, they will come and interact with, and they will change the phenotypic character of that gene. So that condition we are calling as a gene interaction. Already this we have been discussed in our previous class. For that one example we have been studied, incomplete dominance. This is an example for the gene interaction. So this gene interaction, it was discovered by one of the person by name, call it as a Carl Corancia. So he was one of the German botanist here. He conducted this incomplete dominance. Carl Corancia, he conducted this experiment. So what he conducted? He conducted this experiment on the Mirabilis chelpa and also in the Antrinum majus. That is nothing but snapdragon. Even the diagram also they have been mentioned in your textbook here. So textbook in your page number 56. This is the snapdragon plant, and this is conducted in the Mirabilis chelpa, which will produce the plant. It will produce the two different flowers. It will produce, it has taken the two parents here. So this is one parent, this is one parent. So one parent, it is producing the red color flowers. Another parent, it is producing the white color flowers. So for that, genes are nothing but capital R, smaller, because the red color is dominant, whereas white color is recessive in condition. We removed the gametes, and finally, so what he expected means, according to the Mendels, he conducted the monohybrid cross here. According to that monohybrid cross, so what he expected means, he expected that red color flowers will be produced here, but instead of red color, so he saw that pink color flowers has been produced. So he got the shock. So why the pink color has been produced instead of a red color? So a pink color, it is not present in any of the parent here. So then finally he started to identify, and finally he got the answer. What he got the answer means, so the dominant gene is unable to hide the recessive gene completely. So incomplete, it has been hidden here. Whereas in monohybrid cross, what happened is dominant gene has been completely hide the recessive gene. So that's why he, in the F1 generation, he got the tall plants here in monohybrid. Whereas here, the dominant gene is unable to hide the recessive plant. So that's why instead of red color, which color has been produced means the pink color has been produced, but alleles will be same, but the genes will be same. So capital R, smaller. So one R, it has came from one parent, and another R, it has came from the another parent. So genes will be same, but the phenotypic character has been changed here. So which phenotypic character? Your pink phenotype character is got. Next, he contacted the F2 generation. So what he got him is, he got this pattern. So that is means 1:2:1. One red, two pink, and one white color he exhibited. So all these things we have been discussed in our previous class. Phenotypic ratio is 1:2:1, and genotypic ratio is also 1:2:1. So in incomplete dominance, phenotypic and genotypic ratio will be same, because here both 1:2:1. But in the monohybrid cross, so what it is there here means phenotypic ratio is 3:1. In monohybrid cross, phenotypic ratio is 3:1. It is present 3 tall and 1 dwarf. Externally, 3 offsprings are tall in condition and 1 is a dwarf here. Whereas genotypic ratio, if you see, means 1:2:1, it will comes here. So where are they? One is capital T, and 2 is capital T, and 1 is small t. In this pattern we got here. But here phenotypic and genotypic ratio, it will becomes same in the incomplete dominance. So up to here we have been discussed in our previous class, and as I said here, monohybrid or incomplete, it is one of the most important guarantee question for your exam. So you have to write this by putting a checkerboard. So this is the checkerboard, but whatever I have been mentioned here, that time that pattern you have to write. So you have to here in your previous class we have been discussed here. Next, let us discuss the next topic here, gene interaction, by taking another example, call it as a codominance here. So gene interaction, previous class we have been discussed. So the examples for that are means incomplete dominance, codominance, phyliotropy, multiple alleles. So these are all of the examples for the gene interaction. Among that one we have been discussed incomplete dominance. Next let us discuss what it is, then is codominance. So let us know what is the meaning of codominance. Co means what here? Same. So first of all here, co means what here? Co means same. Dominance means what here? Both they are showing the same dominancy. So this is the meaning. So before that, another one example I will tell you here. So in our society, we will find the three types of couples we will find. What is that means? In one couple, in one family, father will be dominant, mother will be recessive in condition, like how in the monohybrid. So either father will be dominated, then mother will be in recessive in condition. So whatever the father will tell, mother she has to accept that one. So who is dominant here? Father is dominant in some families. In some family, mother will be dominant, father will be in a recessive in condition. So whatever the mother, wife will tell for the husband, according to that the husband has to listen. So in this manner, this is also monohybrid only it will comes. Monohybrid, what it will shows here? Monohybrid, it will tells that, so one of the alleles it will be dominant on the another. So one will be that, who will be dominant? It will express his character. Who will be recessive? It will hides its character. So among these two families, either from other, either husband will be dominant or either wife will be dominant. In whose family has a husband will be dominant? So if your wife will be in a recessive in condition, according to whatever the husband will tell, wife will listen for that. In some families, wife will be the dominant and husband will be in the recessive in condition. Whatever the wife will tell here, according to the wife decision, the husband will be work. So this pattern it is fine. But another one type of family is there. So where what happened is, wife is also dominant, husband is also dominant. Husband will tell, I am the owner of this one, so I am dominant. In the same manner, wife, it will, she will not keep silent. Wife, what she will do? Well, like how you are working, I am also doing the work. So I am also a dominant. So this condition we are going to say co-dominance. So here, husband is also dominant, wife is also dominant. So both they are showing their dominancy. So in that condition only we are going to say dominance. That means here, in this phenomena, two contrasting alleles of the same gene express their effect simultaneously, heterozygotes called as codominance. So here, so both the genes what they'll do is simultaneously they'll express their characters here. So tumhe kya kam, mai kya kam. So both what they'll do here is simultaneously they will express their character. So two alleles if they're present means, suppose for that they have been explained by taking an ABO blood group. Suppose you take the AB blood group, assume that AB blood group. So if in our body AB blood group, if it is there here means, so both in whose body AB blood group are there. So for this also gene will be represented. So one gene will be present. So that gene we are retaining it as in the form of a AB gene we are writing here. Now here this is one allele, this is one allele. So both are dominated. So A allele will dominate on the B and B allele will dominate on the A. So due to that one, both are expressing their character, and due to that inside the body the person blood group will be in a AB blood group. The person blood group, it will be in a AB blood group. So that condition we are calling it as a codominance. Co means same here. So both will be in a dominant in condition. This is also dominant, this is also dominant. Both will be in a dominant in a condition they will present. So codominance we are calling. So in this phenomena, two contrasting alleles. So who are the two contrasting alleles? So A is one allele, B is one allele. Two contrasting allele of a same gene. So both are belonging to what here? Both are belonging to the same gene. Both we are considering it as a same gene. And what the effect is gene it is holding means they are bringing a AB blood group in our body. What is the character, phenotypic character they are expressing means they are expressing the AB blood group in our body. So that's why two alleles are present, A allele and B allele. Now both the alleles are expressing the character, both they are showing the dominancy. So wife is also showing the dominancy, husband is also showing the dominancy. So wife will tell, I am not any less than you. So I am, how you are doing the work in the same manner, I am also doing the work. So I will also show my dominancy. In the same manner, husband will also show the dominancy. So I am the head of this family here. So I will also show the dominancy. So both they are expressing the dominancy, and that character we are called as a co-dominance. So in this phenomena of two contrasting alleles of the same gene express their effect simultaneously. Both they are expressing simultaneously. Simultaneously means sat. So the A blood group also they are expressing the character. In the same manner, B blood group also expressing the same character at a time. Simultaneously means what? Yeah, at a time. Ek saath do jane bhi kya kare, they are exhibiting their character. So that's why we are calling it as a co-dominance. So in a heterozygous condition. So they are in a heterozygous condition. A is different from B. B is different from A. So that's why they are in a heterozygote condition. So this condition we are calling it as a co-dominance. Example for this is ABO blood group in man. So co-dominance is the example for the gene interaction. In co-dominance, which is the example, means AB by AB was A group in man here. So co-dominance is explained by taking a blood group of the man. So co-dominance, it is explained by what here? It is explained by taking a ABO blood group here. Next, let us discuss another one here. So another one, what here? As you know very well, multiple alleles. It is also one of the examples for the, well, what here means? It is also one of the example for the gene interaction. So multiple alleles are also even we are calling as a gene polymorphism. Multiple alleles also we are calling, are also even we are calling as a gene polymorphism. More than two alleles located on a particular locus of a homologous chromosomes together responsible for the same phenotypic characters are called multiple alleles. So what is the meaning here means more than two alleles located on a particular locus. So biggerly I will show you here. So this is the chromosome. This is the chromatid. This is one chromatid. This is one chromatid. This is one chromatid. This is one chromatid. So this is the chromosome. And here this is the place. This place what we are calling? This place we are calling it as a locus we are calling. And on this locus who is sitting means genes are sitting. On this place who is sitting? Genes are sitting here. Now usually you know very well. So every character that is held by a gene, this concept you know very well. So inside our body, so how many characters are present? Every character it is held by who? It is held by a gene. Every character it is held by whom? It is held by a gene. Each character it is held by gene. So that's why now how many genes till now what we have been discussed? Two alleles will be present. That is nothing but two alleles means a pair. It will be present like this. Big girl will show you. This is one allele and this is one allele. Normally a pair of gene will be present. Two alleles will be present which is holding one character. So but here name multiple alleles. Alleles means many alleles here. More than two alleles in a particular place. In a particular place. This is the place where these two alleles are sitting. So this is we are calling it as a locus. So more than this one, more than this, the new alleles will come and add to this one. New allele will come and add to this on a particular locus on the same place only. So more than two, either it may be a 3, either it may be a 4, either it may be a 5. More than two alleles if it come and join together to perform the same phenotypic character. So whichever the character they are performing, so to perform that same character, so who will comes here? Many other genes will be come to perform that character is called as multiple alleles. Example, I'll tell you here. Suppose here, so in a bench, two boys are sitting and they are performing the one work. So suppose ek bench mein kya hai? Do bache baithi. So do bache, what they are doing means they are doing the work. What the work they are doing means I allotted the work cutting of a pumpkin. I given one big pumpkin, ek bada kaddu diyo, and I given that work for the homies. Two girls, that means two girls are there, दो बच्चे हैं, and एक बच्ची क्या बोलती है, व्याकरण कैसे Alicia, वो दो जने को मिला को व्याकरण कैसे Jean, and they are performing the phenotypic character, which phenotypic character they are performing, the cutting of a pumpkin, so I have given the big pumpkin, and I have given the work for the two Jeans to cut this pumpkin. So बेंच में बैठे दो बच्चे बैठे दो बच्चे भी क्या है जींस वी आर कॉलिंग ईच वन वी आर कॉलिंग टेज के एक को एक को क्या बोलते हैं अलिस बोलते हैं दो जने इनको मिला को क्या बोलते हैं वी आर कॉलिंग टेज जींस अब ये जीन क्या काम कर रहे कद्दू कट कर रहे सो दे आर डूइंग कटिंग द कद्दू नाउ लेटर व्हाट हैपन मींस अनदर टू फ्रेंड्स अभी इनके दो फ्रेंड्स क्या करते हैं दो एक ये दो एक या दो फ्रेंड्स क्या आते हैं तीन फ्रेंड्स दे विल कम एंड जॉइन विद देम इनके साथ आप इनके साथ बैठती हैं इनके वॉच बेंच पर इनके बाजू बैठती हैं अब बैठ को क्या करती हैं तो दे आर परफॉर्मिंग द सेम कैरेक्टर दे ऑल्सो जॉइन विद देम टू फॉर वॉट ही मीन्स फॉर कटिंग ऑफ द पम्पकिन दे टू मिक्सड विद देम एंड दे स्टार्टेड टू कट द पम्पकिन सो नाउ मोर देन टू एलील्स दे आर कंबाइनिंग टुगेदर एंड ऑल they are performing the same character as they join here the character will not get changed you know join hote sathi chuno kaddu cut karna stop nahi karte or else they didn't change their work ye chodo they didn't stop doing their work or they didn't start to do the other work here but what they are doing here is so they are performing that same work they are performing here so that is counted as a multiple alleles more than two alleles located on a particular locus of homologous chromosome so this is the homologous chromosome more than two alleles more than normally two alleles will be present normally two alleles hote so two se zyada kya hote to they'll come and located on a same locus which is the locus this is the locus they're sitting on the homologous chromosome and together the responsible for the phenotypic character all they're performing the same character where which character the, these two alleles are performing same characters is also performed by this other than the alleles which has been joined that condition we are calling as a multiple alleles or else gene polymorphism we are calling example for this is ABO blood group in man coat color in rabbit and wing shape in drosophila so all these things will be appear in our body due to the multiple allelism only ABO blood group in man mein ABO blood group kise aata hai multiple allelism se coat color in rabbit mein upar ka color kise aata hai multiple allelism and wing shape of drosophila so wing shape of drosophila also it will be appears due to the multiple alleles only so this is about the morphemes multiple alleles now let us next discuss about the co-dominance dominance by taking an ABO blood group here so let us discuss the ABO blood group and their inheritance in man so in a man how this ABO blood group will get inherited how this blood group will get transmitted from parents to the offspring even the blood group will also be transmitted from parents to the offspring how this it will get how this blood group it will get transmitted and even another one thing what I mean for what whichever the blood group are present A B or A B or O for every blood group the gene will be represented so due this transfer of gene even it will carries that transfer of the blood group in the offspring so let us discuss about this one so first of all the blood group one man first were first discovered by German physician called Karl Landsteiner so who discovered the blood group for the first time is blood group were first discovered by Karl Landsteiner so who discovered the blood group for the first time is blood group were first discovered by Karl Landsteiner so little bit sentence difference it will come here just here Whereas this one in your notes, the blood group in man were first discovered by German physician called Karl Landsteiner. So he is the person who first discovered about the blood group in which year means in 1900. In which year he discovered the blood group means in 1900 he discovered the blood group and named as a AB and a O group for this ABO blood group and what he done here means he discovered the blood group and what he given the name for that blood group means he given the name as a blood group A, blood group B and blood group O and for this outstanding work he received the Nobel Prize also for this work what he got here means he got the Nobel Prize also in 1900 930. After 30 years of his discovery, later he got the what means Nobel Prize for his outstanding work. So Karl Landsteiner, he discovered the three types of blood group, which are those means A, B and O. Keep remember, Karl Landsteiner, he is the first person, he discovered the three types of blood group, but we'll find the four types. But three types was discovered by Karl Landsteiner in 1900. A, B and O. It is discovered by Karl Landsteiner in which year means in 1900, and he got the Nobel Prize for his work in 1930. In 1930 he got the Nobel Prize here. Next, in the fourth blood group, later four types of blood groups are there. Later fourth blood group, which we called it as a AB blood group, was discovered by Van de Castolle. So fourth blood group, where it is discovered by Van de Castolle in 1902. After the discovery of these three types of blood group in 1900, later after 2 years, Van de Castolle, he discovered the another one type of, not only three types of blood groups are present, even how many blood groups are present, four different types of blood groups are present here. So fourth blood group, which is, that means fourth blood group is AB blood group. So finally, how many types of blood groups are present in the human beings, means four different type of blood groups, A, B, AB and O. Among the three, it is identified by Karl Landsteiner, and one it is identified by Van de Castolle. So Van de Castolle, he discovered the AB blood group. Remaining A, B and O blood group, it is discovered by the humans, it is discovered by the Karl Landsteiner. So for that work they got the Nobel Prize here. Both of them, what they got here is Nobel Prize they got here. Next, blood group system. So let us discuss how this blood group system, it is present in our body. Now human blood has two major components, namely blood corpuscles, RBC, WBC and platelets and plasma. Already you have been studied in your previous classes. In your previous classes, what you studied here, you have been studied about the blood, you have been studied. So blood, it is made up of two substances. So which are those means? Blood, it contains the two types of components. One is the blood corpuscles, another one is the plasma. Even as I said in my previous class also, so assume that your blood is like a gulab jamun, as I said in my first year. So assume that your blood is like a gulab jamun. So how the gulab jamun, in the gulab jamun, so gulab jamun round ball jamun will be present in the same manner. So we having the what we having, we having the what we having, we having the corpuscles will be present, but blood corpuscles will be present, we having the blood corpuscles will be present. Which are the blood corpuscles? Means RBC, WBC and platelets. Three different type of jamuns are present. One jamun we account as RBC, another jamun we account as WBC, another jamun we account as platelets. And this jamun, it is present in the shira. Which is the shira? Plasma is the shira. So in this plasma, so what it contains? Blood corpuscles are present, or else even blood cells will be present. Which are the blood cells? RBC, WBC and platelets will be present. So that's why human blood has two major components. One is the blood corpuscles, another one is the plasma. Now if you come to the RBC, among the blood corpuscles, if you come to the RBC, so the membrane of the RBC contains two types of glycoprotein called antigen. So this is the RBC. This is the RBC. So RBC membrane. So this is the membrane. Membrane means outer membrane. This RBC outer membrane, what it contains means, it contains the two types of glycoproteins, it is present. So above the surface of the RBC, so RBC is covered by a membrane. So RBC, it is red in color, it is a circular in manner. So it contains the two types of glycoprotein. It contains how many types of glycoprotein? Two types of glycoproteins are present. Glycoproteins are present, and that glycoprotein, what we are calling it as a antigen. What we call them as a antigen. Similarly, plasma membrane. So plasma means what? Yeah, the fluid which is present in that. So plasma, what it contains means, it contains the two types of proteins called antibodies. So RBC also contains the, RBC membrane also contains the protein, and even in the same manner, plasma which is present, plasma also it contains the type of a protein. So plasma, which type of a protein it is contains? Plasma, it contains a specific type of protein, it is present. That specific type of protein, the plasma, what it contains? Plasma, it is a fluid. Plasma is like a shira. So plasma, what it contains? It contains the specific protein. RBC, what type of protein it contains? It contains the glycoprotein. Remember this one, RBC membrane, it contains the protein, and even plasma also contains the protein. RBC protein, what we are calling glycoprotein. So the plasma, it contains a protein called it as a specific protein. For this specific protein, we given the name as a antibodies. What we given? We given the name as a antibodies. We are given it as a antibodies, whereas the glycoprotein which is present on the RBC, we call them as a antigen. Now, so how many here in our blood? So we having the this antigen and antibodies are the basis for the identification of the blood group. Identification of the blood group. These antigen and antibodies are the basis for the identification of the blood group. So the antigen and the antibodies are the basis. So antigen, to whom we recognize, antigen are present on the RBC surface. So whereas antibodies, where it will present, antibodies will be present on the plasma membrane. So plasma membrane also contains the protein, RBC also contains the protein. So RBC protein we call it as a antigen, plasma proteins we call it as a antibody. So that's why antigen and antibodies are the basic for the identification of the blood group. So let us discuss about this antigen and antibodies. Antigens even we are calling it as a immunogens or agglutinogens. Antigens even what we are calling it as a immunogens or agglutinogens. So now antigens means these are the glycoproteins. Just now as I said you here, these are the glycoproteins. They will be present. They are present on the membrane of the RBC. This is the RBC. So these RBC, RBCs are the blood cells which will present in the blood. So above the RBC is covered by a membrane. RBC, it is covered by a membrane. This membrane, it contains what it contains? It contains the glycoprotein. That glycoprotein we are calling it as a antigen. They induce the immune system, the production of specific antibodies. So there are two types of antigens, namely antigen A and antigen B. What is the work of this antigen means? What is the work of this antigen means? They induce the immune system for production of specific antigen. So what are they contains the proteins. Antigen, it is a protein. Which type of protein? Glycoprotein. It is a glycoprotein. It is a glycoprotein. This antigen, it will induces, it will alerts to our immune system. In our body, immune system, it is present. It will wake up for the immune system. Like how your parents will wake up for you to sit and read in the early morning in the same manner. So this antigen, it will induce us to the immune system. It will wake up for the immune system. For what means to produce the antibodies? Because immune system will produce the antibodies. So that's why who is ordering here means antibody, antigen, it is ordering. Antigen, it is wake up for the immune system. So according to that, immune system will produce the antibodies. So it will produce the specific antibodies it will produce. And there are two types of antigens are present. So here antigen is present. How many types of antigen will be present? Two types of antigen. Which we are those means antigen A and antigen B. So antigen A and antigen B. So these are the two types of antigen A and antigen B. It is present, which is inducing the immune system. What they'll do? They will induce us to the immune system. To whom it will induce us? They'll induce us to the immune system. And according to induce us, the immune system, it will start for production of the antibodies. So as the two types of antigens are there, antibodies will also produce. Two types of antibodies will be produced. So two types of antigens are present. So that's the antibodies. How many it will produce? Antibodies will produce two. This is about the antigen. Understand? Antigen means, first of all, where it will be present? It will present on the RBC membrane. So it is contains the glycoprotein. That glycoprotein we are calling it as a antigen. So we having the two types of antigen, antigen A and antigen B. And what is the work of this antigen means? This antigen, it will induce us, it will alert to the immune system. It will wake up for the immune system. For what means? It will give the order to the immune system to produce the antibodies. So according to the listening of the order to the immune system, it will produce the antibodies. So this is the antigen. Like as soon as we enter into the hotel, we will give the order for the waiter. According to our order, the waiter will serve for us in the same manner. So according to the order of the antigen, so what it means, immune system will produce the antibodies. So this is about your antigen. Next, if you come to the antibodies, we are calling it as agglutinins. So this is agglutinogen and this is the agglutinins. So these are the specific protein. Antibodies means what? Just now we have been discussed. It is also a type of a specific protein. Where it will present means they will present in the plasma of the blood. So plasma of the blood they will be present. And they will be produced by whom? They will be produced by the immune system. So as the antigens, they will alert for the immune system. And immune system will produce the antibodies. That antibodies, they will go and settle in the plasma. So antibodies will settle in the plasma. So RBC membrane ke upar glycoprotein it will be present. Glycoprotein present rehta hai, that glycoprotein we are calling as a antigen. Glycoprotein ko kya bolte antigen we are calling. This antigen it will induces, it will alerts for the immune system and it will produce as the antibodies. Who will producing the antibodies? Immune system it is producing the antibodies, but who is giving order means antigen it is giving order for the immune system. According to the order, immune system it is producing the antibodies. So and that antibodies where it will come and present, it will be present means it will present in the plasma of the blood. So two types of antigens are there, antigen A and antigen B. So that's why how many types of antibodies we'll get here? We'll get the two types of antibodies, which are those means anti A antibodies, anti B antibodies. These are the two types, because two types of antigen are present, antigen A and antigen B. So antigen A antibodies, anti B antibodies it will be present. So like the two types will be present, and where they'll be present? They'll present in the plasma membrane. They are produced by the immune system in response to the specific antigen. So that's why according to the response of the specific antigen, antibodies will be present. So this is about your antigen and the antibodies. Next, let us discuss about the blood group. So this blood group we'll discuss in our next class.